Hello YouTube. So you'll notice my St. Patrick's Day tree has been changed over from the Mardi Gras one, so it's just green and white now for St. Patty's Day. It sounded good in my head, it really did. I'm so sorry for that. I'm still gonna go and buy some specifically, you know, paint St. Patrick's Day decorations. This just has green and white on it, so it's just in the early stages, but we're pretty damn good. So by now you've read the title and you're probably wondering why I'm doing such an unbalanced list. The answer is simply because I work as an extra, so if the pros are equal to the cons, then I really have no business being one. Overall, I think it's a worthwhile and beneficial experience for anyone who has what it takes. You owe yourself the opportunity to see how shit really goes down. For very real. I only do background at the beginning of the year when I have Christmas money saved up, so it really doesn't matter if I gig or not. Eventually I have to get a 9-to-5 job because I run out of money, but I'm not doing it for money anyway. See, I had to cut there because I almost couldn't say that with a straight face, but I'm really not. If I can pay my rent with it, great, but you should never expect that to happen. It's really hard to support yourself entirely as a background artist in Los Angeles nowadays. There's too many actors moving here, juxtaposed against extras who never gave up or advanced to real roles, thus clogging the pool. I've been an extra off and on for 2 years, and you know, I have about that much time left to make something happen with it. And if I don't, it's the commendable thing to move on. A lot of extras will greatly disagree with this, but you find that they do this for their own selfish reasons. I'm only doing it for fun and bragging rights, which leads me to the first of 5 cons. These statements do not pertain to other casting services in Los Angeles, which all suck because they charge you for non-union work that only pays minimum wage. Central Casting is free. Number 1 con. It's no substitute for an actual income or job. People who brag about doing background for 10 years or more should be ashamed. It's a temporary position, a mere stepping stone to other opportunities. It's like being a production assistant for 10 years. You should have naturally progressed to something else. The fact that you haven't is a very strong indication that it's just not going to happen for you. It's really not steady work. You know, one day you're playing an upscale Caucasian in Beverly Hills and you're on top of the world, and the next you're homeless in downtown Los Angeles. By that, of course, I mean you're playing someone homeless in downtown Los Angeles, not actually being homeless. Although it can happen. Once you do that gig, you really are at the mercy of whenever the hell that check decides to come in the mail. Riding high in April, shot down in May. I'm convinced background acting is what that life's about. I think they were originally gonna call it That Showbiz, but since that title existed already, they changed it to That's Life, also to kind of broaden the scope, make it about, you know, life and not just about the few people who work in the industry. Read the lyrics. It could be interpreted that way very easily. Number 2 con. Extras love to complain. Particularly if it's a large call. 500 people or more, referred to as cattle calls, can be brutal. I've witnessed fights, thefts, arguments at pretty much every job that size. The film Blood Simple opens with,
"The world is full of complainers. The fact is, nothing comes with a guarantee."
Truer words have never been spoken about this business we call show. Despite the quote not actually being about the entertainment industry, it still applies. EWA, or Extras with Attitude, as I call them, have a singularity to their plight. They haven't made it yet, and boy, does that piss them off. I once saw a 250-pound black guy tell a 100-pound female AD to hurry this shit the fuck up. I never saw him around again. Which leads me to one of the pros later to come. So stick around for that. Number 3 con. Extras love to brag. I get it, we all want to think we can actually make it in Hollywood. Odds are, though, we're way more likely to be murdered. I hear extras go on and on about how they've made it, but if they were doing that well, they wouldn't be an extra. And don't show me a picture of you with a famous person. That does not impress me. I can almost guarantee you they hated taking that picture. They get paid handsomely to be photographed, like they want you to get likes while they get nothing. And I'm positive that selfie of you and Snoop Dogg was from the Wax Museum. Background actor and lesbian impersonator. Hold on, I can do it. Background actor and lesbian impersonator Jesse Hyman has been doing this since he played Petey in American Pie 2, his first featured background performance. Cut to 20 years later and he's considered the greatest background actor of all time, according to one YouTuber. Please, I did a Silicon Valley with that prick, and let me tell you something, that know-it-all fat ass has been doing this for 20 years, he's had ample opportunities, and he's squandered every single one of them. He makes extras look bad, and believe me, we don't need the help, buddy. Thank you. Always say thank you. Number 4 con. Background acting is the opposite of acting. Proof is in the fact that extras as a whole care less about the craft and more about craft services. I'm no actor, but I try to imagine myself in the role I'm playing. Makeup and wardrobe greatly help with this, especially if it's a time period that I didn't live through. But I listen to actors going on and on about overtime and meal penalties. Yeah, I don't think that's what Robert De Niro's priorities were when he first got into acting. But as I stated before, it's not a real job and you cannot rely on it to pay the rent. You just can't. That's for when you get real roles. This is not that moment. Moreover, background actors are supposed to be generic looking and should only add presence to the extent of the reality of such a role. If you're walking in the background and it's distracting, you have failed as an extra. The whole point is to not be noticed, whereas actors, generally speaking, are the ones who stood out from the crowd.
Hey, opposite is opposite. He's got nothing!
Number 5 con. Casting directors can be spiteful. It's so arbitrary. Some think you will never find work because you have the wrong look. Others will say you're perfect. One thing that remains true is no one sets out to be a casting director. You know the expression, those who can't do teach? Well, those who can't act cast. And there are some out there who are bitter about this and have the power to blacklist aspiring actors they personally do not like. So be as nice to them as possible. Sleep with the enemy if you have to. A way of life, not just a Julia Roberts film. Now that we're done with that content, we'll start with the most obvious pro. Number 1 pro, you get to see famous people. Sometimes if you're lucky enough, you're chosen to interact with the principal actor. In some cases, that could be a very famous person that you would otherwise never get the chance to speak with. To boot, you have that moment forever on film. And this could be a show you watch and now you're part of it. If you're an up-and-coming actor, this is tantamount to your wedding day. Number 2 pro, you can make good money short term. Even though this sounds sweet, and it is, be wary. Most gigs are only for one day, so while you can make hundreds of dollars in a single night while keeping your clothes on, you could also go a week without working. This may sound like a con, but many times a check came in much larger than expected and it saved my ass. Trust me, it's a pro. Just be wary. Number 3 pro, it makes you better than you are. The one thing I have found universally true on set is almost everyone is extremely nice. The assholes truly do get weeded out. When I'm on set, I always try to learn everyone's name and say thank you. Always say thank you. Even to the caterers. You would be amazed at what you can accomplish by being positive and smiling. Sometimes the location is too hot, other times it's too cold, or the wardrobe is uncomfortable, but there's nothing you can do except learn to tolerate it. Discomfort is a large part of being an actor. Use it or lose it, but don't lose it, like get mad on set. Don't ever get mad on set. Entertainment largely has to come from a place of positivity if it wants to grow into something. I've booked gigs for several days, and after a couple, I was much more considerate of the people around me, much more than I would ever be in my ordinary life. I mean, I don't want the blemish on my record, sure, but I'm also, you know, a much happier person when I'm working and on set. It kind of works both ways. Number 4 pro, you eat like a king. One of the Coen brothers stated in an interview just how easy it is to gain 20 pounds in 6 weeks on set. The days are long and setups can be time consuming, not to mention waiting for a celebrity to come out of their trailer. The hours press on, but your stomach will never growl. We once broke for dinner, and when we returned back to holding, they had ordered like 25 pizzas for us. And we literally had just eaten. Also, being an extra, I have to say, you know, being at the bottom of the totem pole is liberating because no one expects much out of you. You can literally do nothing and impress people. Number 5 pro, you can meet some really great people. It's no surprise you're going to meet people just like you. Like a crash course in self-awareness, you may see the best and worst of yourself. People are going to annoy you on set. Try to get away from that if possible. Never confront an extra that is bothering you. If you really hate this person, don't ever associate with them, as this could insinuate yourself in the very thing that they're doing that's bothering you. Because believe it or not, we're always being watched. The extras you see time and time again are typically the nicest ones, so befriend them. Befriend the shit out of them. Number 6 pro. No one is going to pay you this much to do this little. I challenge any extra to counter this argument. If they have a better paying while simultaneously easier job, why are they wasting their time here? I would drop the mic, but it's expensive and clipped on my shirt. You spend most of your time waiting or sitting, or eating. For every minute of finished product, there are hours spent doing nothing and getting paid for it. Even when you wait in long lines to return props, another line to return wardrobe, and yet even another long line to sign out, you get paid for all that time. In fact, rarely is the time out on my voucher the actual time. They give you extra time presumably to pay you for your commute home, which is really considerate. That, or it's just a dumb fuck thing they don't realize is costing productions thousands daily. Either way, I'm reaping the benefits. Number 7 pro. You get a real world understanding of how show business actually is. The only way to find out is to experience it for yourself. Almost all sets are chill and positive. They have to be. Blu-rays and DVDs have special features with behind-the-scenes featurettes, but these supplements, like the film itself, have been edited to appear a certain way. And now with CGI becoming commonplace, the purity of the filmed image has lost that truth of reality. I've watched many featurettes and I feel like none of them really capture the way it actually is. I've deduced the reason why is because the person who made it, most likely an assistant editor or an intern, didn't want to piss anybody off by showing things that might conflict with the themes of the movie. It's very political, and the bottom line is it's just a really slow-moving, highly technical process that wouldn't interest the average moviegoer. Number 8 pro. If your shit gets stolen, production has to reimburse you. My $700 bicycle was stolen, and I was livid. Within 2 weeks, production ordered a new model of the same bicycle, which was now 3 years old, and delivered it assembled to my apartment. They even paid for the Lyft ride I had to take the night it was stolen.
Pretty good.
Number 9. There is a lot of downtime. It's the only job I can do on no sleep. In fact, it's the only job I can do where I can sleep on the job. My first gig, I was so excited I couldn't sleep, and so I didn't sleep. Then I ended up using it. I was playing a construction worker, and these guys, they work long hours, they get little sleep, and it starts to show. The fact that I looked so tired worked well for the scene. I ended up getting chosen for a close-up. I was out of focus, but I was still more featured than anyone else that day. And it was my first time being an extra, so you could imagine how excited I was. I also bring a laptop for the hours that I could be in holding. So the way I look at it, I'm getting paid to write, edit videos, and watch movies. Yes, please. Number 10 pro. Anyone can advance to the next level of their film career. Many famous people got their start in background. Central Casting even displays this proudly on their wall of fame. The likes of The likes of Oscar winner Brad Pitt, Kesha, even the guy getting rimmed in Borat. Boy, I bet Kesha's grateful for that sentence. You could be that person. Most likely you aren't, but the point is it can happen to anyone, which technically means you. So keep those fingers crossed and never argue with anyone, and it may happen for you. And with that, we have come to the end of the list. Good luck to all the new actors who just moved to Los Angeles. And veteran background, if I could get you guys to just stick around for a minute. This pertains to people who have been doing it for over 10 years with no end in sight. I beg you to stop what you're doing immediately. At the very least, take a break for a few years and try something else. Then you can do your little comeback tour all you want, as long as you promise to go away. People of all ages move out here and they all deserve a shot. All you're really doing is taking work from these people. Not to mention you're allowing yourself to be stagnant as an extra. I can't emphasize this enough. There are too many people out here doing background for too damn long nowadays. Unfortunately, this industry tends to attract people who can't take no for an answer. Like no business I know, more like no business to accept a no. But the climate is changing, and hopefully this downward trend will fade with it. I'm hopeful. You know, I'm also grateful to Central Casting. I've dealt with other agencies, and most of them will cancel you at the last minute. They're the only dependable and free service in all of Los Angeles. They've leveled the playing field. Everyone gets a chance until they fuck up. When you're new to LA, that's a better deal than you're going to get anywhere else in town. So take the advice for what it's worth, and again, good luck.